Hi viewers, welcome to our YouTube channel Electrical Lectures. In this video, I will be showing you the difference between continuous time and discrete time signals. The difference between these two types of signals is related with the nature of time axis. If the time axis is continuous or the signal is defined for all the values of time, then the signal will be continuous, otherwise it will be discrete. As an example, let us draw a continuous time signal in the form of a sine wave. So here you can see that this sine wave is defined for all the values of time. Therefore, this signal will be considered as continuous time. Even if the amplitude axis or y axis is not continuous, but if the time axis is continuous, we will say that the signal is continuous time. So we consider another example to consider this fact. So here the signal is like this. So it is a digital signal because the amplitude axis contains finite values, but since it is defined for all the values of time, therefore it is a continuous time signal. On the other hand, let us consider a couple of examples for discrete time signal. A discrete time signal is also called a sequence. So as an example, we consider again a sine wave in discrete form. This sine wave is only defined for discrete values of time and not all the values of time. So it will look like this. A discrete time signal can either be in the form of weighted impulses, or it can also be in the form of weighted pulses. To consider this, let us have another example in which I am going to draw a discrete time signal in the form of weighted pulses. But remember, those weighted pulses will not be defined for all the values of time. So a discrete time pulse signal will be like this. So here you can see that the pulses are not defined for all the values of time. There are silent intervals where nothing is defined for some values of time. So as a summary, you can say that if the time axis of any signal is continuous or the signal is defined for all the values of time, then the signal will be called continuous time. Otherwise, if the signal is not defined for all the values of time, then the signal will be declared as discrete time signal or sequence. Thank you for watching this video. Stay tuned to our channel Electrical Lectures.